As you've heard, my name is Slavko Hadzic, and I'm coming from Sarajevo, capital of Bosnia and Herzegovina, where I pastor church for the last 13 years. Besides pastoring local church, I have two passions in ministry, and one is evangelism, the other one is preaching. Some 10 years ago, I got involved with the FOCLID and with Lindsay, Michael Green, Michael Lutz, many other guys, and I learned a lot from them. Part of my life story is that before conversion, in the late 80s, early 90s, when I was in my early 20s years of life, I was involved with organized crime in Bosnia and Herzegovina. And today God is using that part of my life to share gospel with the people. As I said, I'm evangelist, and I like also to speak to people about God, to preach evangelistic messages. And when I just became Christian, I was somehow almost hiding that part of my life when I was involved with organized crime, because I was thinking maybe it will reject people, what they will think of me, or, you know, or I would think also maybe, you know, people would think, oh, I was not that bad. Maybe he needed Jesus, but I don't need. But later in my life and ministry, I realized that really it is a very powerful tool, personal testimony. By the way, Lindsay asked me for the title of tomorrow's talk. Talk will be in court to free, in room 33. And title is From Mafia to Ministry, Power of Personal Testimony in Evangelism. And I preached many evangelistic messages without testimony, and I gave my testimony many times without preaching biblical truths. And both are good, but I most like when I do it combined. Why? Because, you know, biblical truths are very important, as all of you know. Bible is written word of God. It's very important that we publicly proclaim His written word. But testimony somehow confirms those biblical truths by our life experience. And from the other side, life experience or personal testimony is great thing. It's probably the only thing which I know all answers which can be given to me. Michael was just speaking about importance of questions and how we are afraid of some questions. And there are many questions from the Bible which maybe I don't know to answer, or I will not give good answer, but there is no single question from my life and my personal relation with Jesus that I cannot answer. If there is some sin in my life that it is still active and I'm hiding it, and then that are the questions about my life that I can be afraid of. But if it is something what is behind me, what God set me free of, then I would be very happy to talk about that. But basically it's very, there are, I would say, two types of evangelistic message, and which I do at least, where I integrate my personal testimony. And one is, let's say, topical, and the other one is exposition. So what I mean by that, if I say topical, it can be title anything from freedom, from satisfaction, from love. And then I put a message and I bring my life story around that title or topic. And then I try to follow that topic through all evangelistic message, and I try to emphasize parts of my testimony and my personal story which are speaking about that specific topic. The other way is to find, for example, you know, one piece from the scripture, and then through that part of the scripture to share gospel with the people, but it has to be connection points with my life. So, for example, recently I started to do talk on transformation, and speaking about life of Zacchaeus, my life and listener life. So I say in the beginning, I will speak today about three person. One is from Bible, many years ago, the other one is me and my life, but third one, that's you and it's about your life. And then I make connecting points. When I was very young Christian, I remember in some disciple classes, they were teaching me how testimony has to have three parts: your life before Christ, how you encounter Jesus and became Christian, and what change that bring in your life later. And I still today try always to have all that three parts, so I always start from before Jesus. And as I said, if, for example, topic of the talk is satisfaction, I would start from the point why satisfaction is important. Why is important to people? Why is it possible to find ultimate satisfaction? And try to make connections with the listeners that they can recognize themselves. I can bring a few quotes or, you know, a few biblical verses, but then I transfer to myself, and then I speak how I was trying to find satisfaction. I can mention how people in the world do try to find satisfaction. And then I say how I was trying to find satisfaction, and then I'm trying to make connection between listeners and the topic of the talk to get their attention. Then I'm trying to make connection between me and them. And then after that, I bring the problem in. What is the problem? Why is so hard to find ultimate satisfaction? Bring how God created us on His image, and the problem of sin, how we are separated from Him. And I speak also about my life before Jesus and which sins were separating me from the God. That part of the story is attractive to people and interesting, and I'm sorry, but that's the fact, that people are interested in bug things, in mafia guy, but I try not to put focus on that. Focus all the time, of course, should be on Jesus and change which He brought, but I have to tell them and to underline and to show that need was necessary, that change was necessary. And then speak, of course, about what Jesus did, how I encounter Him, how I've heard about what He did, and how I had intellectually to understand, and then to make decision to accept Him as a Lord and the Savior. Then usually at that point, sometimes at the very end, but sometimes at that point, I put challenge in front of people. I give invitation, I ask if there are those who are ready to accept Jesus and to follow Him, and after that pray prayer, but then I continue talk and speak what change that brought into my life. As I said, sometimes I give invitation at the end, after the change, and also want to make sure always to include also those in invitation, those who are not ready yet, to encourage them to stay in touch, to talk to Christians, to come to meetings, etc.